Lord, I know your ways are higher than mine. I'll follow your leading. Trust your design. In moments like these, I sing out a song. I sing out a praise song to you, Lord. In moments like these, I lift up my hands. I lift up my hands to the
more you see one day that needs. sheriff turned Joseph bad. The warden made him prison lad, and inmates told him dreams that had.
Yes, do that you might know, boy. My name's Drink Worthy, and to sum it up, I sum for Pharaoh's food and cup, and he's the Pharaoh's baker.
My friends just call me Doughboy.
I trained the most delightful vine, who grapes it was supremely fine. I turned them into splendid wine and gave it to the Pharaoh.
The interpretation is from the Lord. He tells me that your charge is sore, so give him praise, for in 3 days
I'm delightfully splendid.
Good news is you cook quite well. The bad news I don't care to tell.
Oh, go ahead.
3 days you're dead.
You sure you ain't mistaken?
You better sing a song real loud.
And sure enough, on judgment day, the judge restored the butler's pay. But as for Doughboy, let's just say the baker met his maker.
You better sing a song.
One song is not enough.
You need another.
Go when the going gets rough.
The butler made a promise that he'd go before the Pharaoh to tell him Joseph's situation and the way he'd been treated. The promise was forgotten, and the days turned into years. But through it all, God provided patience and the faith that Joseph needed.
When a doubt and disappointment hide the morning sun, when all my dreams have ended, all my songs are sung, his spirit soars within me. Every doubt is gone, I see a new horizon and I sing a brand new song. For in his perfect timing, up ahead a light is shining, and I know the dawn will be.
Soon.
The dreamer has been summoned by Pharaoh himself. Walking through the palace halls, Joseph recalls all that's happened and where he's been. After 2 years in a dungeon, he's finally remembered. His trust in God's direction is rewarded once again.
Father God, I feel your hand again, pressing me to move with your plan again, lifting high all that's worthwhile again, helping me to rise up and see.
Young man, and let me tell just why I sent for you. My butler tells me that you can interpret dreams and visions. And last night in a fitful sleep, I had exactly two. My dream saw seven healthy cattle grazing by the river. Then from the Nile in single file came seven more besides. These cows were thin and haggard, and their eyes said they were hungry. They snuck up on the fat cows and they swallowed those raw hides. The second dream was stranger. I saw seven giant corn stalks attack my seven scrawny stalks invading from the south. Again, the small ones ate the big ones. I can't understand it. I knew a corn stalk comes on ants, but where to get the mouth?
The future is revealed to Egypt by Almighty God. After 7 years of plenty will come seven famine years. My advice to Pharaoh, appoint a wise commissioner to store food supplies before the food all disappears.
God's spirit is upon you, Joseph. Your advice is taken. I make you commissioner, my second in command. God's wisdom must be in you. Arise, take my ring. I give you charge of all the land.
The new beginning came in many different ways for Joseph. He married an Egyptian girl, began a family, and quickly set in motion all the programs he'd planned. But through all of his good fortune, the memory of his own sufferings gave him a heart of true compassion for the people of the land.
Every time I see a smiling face, I wish it would rub off and set a pace to chase the world around, that hate could not be found and left no trace. Everything in harmony, what a world it would be.
I wish the entire human race each day could feel a tender, warm embrace, have shoes upon their feet, and have enough to eat, live happily. If only man and woman were free, what a world it would be.
Within my mind, that each and every one of us could find a place without despair, if only we would dare, sometime, somewhere. If all of us could find the key, what a world it would be.
Brother brothers but decided to wait and reveal himself at a later date. When the brothers walked up, they didn't have a clue that the governor was you-know-who. I'm scared.
Me too. I can hardly walk.
Just let me handle all the talk. Oh, great vice-bearer of the land, we kiss the ground on which you stand. Your radiance lights the morning sky.
And you seem like a real swell guy.
We come before you on our knees.
We humbly ask you, pretty please.
Just make your point and make it plain.
Could we swap some silver for some grain?
It seems to me extremely weird that each one of you wears a beard. Those whiskers are a cheap disguise. I think you're undercover spies.
Say what?
Now this here bushy beard was made from 5 full years without a blade.
Oh no, great pharaoh number two. We never tried to spy on you.
We look alike, we're brothers, see. We're one big happy family.
Have all the brothers come for grain?
No.
At best explained, there were 12 brothers, but not today. One stayed with dad, one passed away.
I'll release 9 of you on bail, but one must stay down here in jail. When you've returned with the other son, I'll believe you and free everyone.
So 9 returned and one was kept, as Joseph turned his back and softly wept.
Back, 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 again and back, back, back. Back, 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 we got our bags all packed. We put our sacks on camel's backs and now these boys are making tracks. Back, 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 to Canaan, back, back, back. Back, 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 to Canaan all the way.
Joseph sent food back with his brothers, but he had rather have sent himself. He longed to see his father and the masquerade. And yet, had his brothers been forgiven, had the past really been forgotten, Joseph needed inner peace as he went alone to pray.
Lord, I need you to be all the gentleness in me. I've been trying by myself, struggling all along. From the very start, I knew that I must depend on you. Here I am depending, Lord. The rest is up to you.
I made the long journey with my brothers back to Egypt, but I couldn't understand why the governor had sent for me. We came upon the palace, and I was awed by its beauty. I'd never seen such wonderful sights in all my memory. The servants took us to the banquet hall. The governor was to meet us. We were surprised to find that a lavish feast had been prepared. From behind a satin curtain stepped the governor in all his splendor. When he asked us how our father was, I wondered why he cared. He'd arranged to have a seat in the order of our ages. We couldn't understand, and we were all astonished that he would even know. He looked at me and said, "You must be Benjamin, the youngest." Then he quickly turned and told us he had to go. At daybreak, we departed with our loaded sacks of grain. We'd hardly left the town when we were stopped by Pharaoh's men. They opened my sack and found the governor's silver goblet. Then they arrested us and took us to his house again. My brothers fell before him and they begged him to show mercy. The governor made his servants leave. Emotion filled his voice. "There's no need to be afraid," he said. "I'm your brother Joseph, and all has been forgiven. So forget the past and rejoice." At first, no one could believe their ears. So he broke the silence. "Please don't feel guilty. It's really me, Joseph. It was God who sent me here to save lives during the famine and preserve our family." Then we all embraced and wept, knowing God's ways are higher than our own.
You are the one who put the stars up in the sky.
sing a hallelujah, sing a hallelujah, joining our hands. Hallelujah, 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 joining our hands. Hallelujah, 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 brothers again. Raising our hands, we sing a hallelujah, sing a hallelujah. Raising our hands, raising our hands, we sing a hallelujah, sing a hallelujah. Raising our hands, yeah.
Hallelujah,
yeah.
Hallelujah,
yeah.
Hallelujah.
Raising our hands, yeah.
Goodbye, my brothers, and shalom. Take these food supplies back home. Go to my father when you've arrived and tell him that his son Joseph is still alive. Then have everyone pack their things and return here to the land of kings, where you'll all stay and live with me, a reunited family.
I can't believe it, I touch you with my hand. The little boy I thought was gone is a ruler in this land. Well, if the Lord will grant it, I'll live here by your side. Then you'll know that my heart is full of pride.
Life and all that he became, I see the way the Lord can use us if we have the courage to trust him, obey him, and praise his name.
Praise his name and say it's happened. Let the power of God become alive in your life. Just praise the Lord, just praise the Lord, sing hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise his name and see it happen. There's a joy will reign as you consider his love. Just praise the Lord, just praise the Lord, sing hallelujah, hallelujah.
After more of his face, are you barren and don't know why?
Won't you come to the watering place where the voice of the singers arise,
where the praises swell, the kingdom comes to dwell.